Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of D4, Dark Dreams Don't Die. Alright, let's go ahead and get right started. We were in an airplane last time, almost trampling to our death, but we're safe. We kicked some ass. A mannequin did not make it through. A few seconds of silence for the mannequin, everyone. Alright. That poor, poor mannequin. All right. Olivia Jones disappeared. Suspicious. You mean people don't just disappear and it's not suspicious? Man, who would have known that? Who is this? Dr. Roland. I guess he's not a doctor. He looked like a doctor, but I think he just like had a face mask on. I was just like, oh my God, he's a doctor. He's a surgeon. Oh, there he is. Hello, friend. Hi there, friend. If I'm all... evidence, 4 pieces remaining. Damage cover.
The cherry blossoms and snow are switched. No mistake. So what does that mean?
Means you're crazy, sir. Means you're crazy. What am I grabbing? Anything I can grab here? I don't want to read any more hockey information. Alright guys, I'm going to take a few seconds. We're going to pause it. We're going to read this all on our own time. Oh, no, I'll read it. Ice hockey stands along football, baseball, and basketball as one of the four major sports and is especially popular on the East Coast of America. Just what is so appealing about ice hockey then? We asked a particular avid fan for his take. The power and speed of the players, man. There's no other rush like it. No sport as fast and as brutal as hockey, man. No other. Ice hockey players reach speeds of 30 miles per hour and quite literally crash into each other in order to prevent the other team's attacks. When shot, the puck can reach speeds over 100 miles per hour. The speedy matches and violent clashes between the teams are the reason why it's known as the Frozen Duel, providing an appeal that cannot be found in other sports. Alright guys, I'm so glad we took the time to read that. Oh, scrapbooking at its best. It won't let me out of the thing.
The cherry blossoms and snow are switched. No mistake. So what does that mean?
I think it shouldn't make me look at those, but it does. Alrighty, any more things that I can stare at? No, okay, moving on. Hello, sir, are you okay? Push, oops.
The door looks fine.
Alright guys, in case you're wondering, oop. No, go back. It gave me...
The door looks fine.
Look around. Alright. Oh, nope. I just want to make sure, because last time I didn't look around.
The door looks fine.
Alright, looking around. Alright, it looks fine. Push. Okay. Just want you guys to know that door looks fine. Nothing over here. Alrighty, moving on to the next step. One step at a time. Hello, ma'am. Push.
Ha ha ha. Dumbass.
Call me a dumbass? I push you so hard.
Doesn't this shaking feel odd to you?
Again? Okay. No. It's a plane. It's supposed to shake, ma'am. It's supposed to shake. Okay, and I already went over here. Alright, over here. Hello, Amanda. Hi there, Kiki. Hello, ma'am. There's nothing over here. Step up to business first class. Old photograph, smiling, wife and daughter.
Marshall, are you okay?
Hi, Marshall.
What's with the attitude? I'm only asking because I was worried. You'd think nothing happened at all.
I don't need your jabber, boy.
What's that supposed to mean? Real blood.
Derek Buchanan. I'm not sure why, but he seems determined to ignore me.
But his daughter, what's good with his daughter?
About your daughter. Does she look like you? If she does, well, that's gotta be one unhappy kid.
Ouch!
Voted most likely to be carved from stone. No prom date for her. Just having you as a father is enough to scare the boys off, I bet.
But I'm trying
that's
to
a surprise. You're the last person I'd expect to be carrying a picture of your family.
Oh, damn.
Listen up. I don't know who you are.
I thought you already said you knew who
but
I was.
If you want to keep sucking down air. Never.
I feel pretty. Oh, so pretty. I feel pretty and witty and
as
gay.
As for your other inquiry, my daughter does not need the likes of you worrying about her. She looks like her mother. Thank you very much.
Are you okay, David?
Marshall Buchanan doesn't know who I am? There's something very odd going on here.
I was just about to say,
but
didn't he just...
What is it?
Didn't he know who you were?
Marshall.
I'll be slapped with a match penalty if I push my luck any further. I'd better look for another way before I'm sent off for good.
Push.
My turn, asshole.
Bye, Marshall. Nah. You can't touch us. Oh yeah, we're number one. Da-da-da-da-da-da!
Nothing says Boston quite like this.
Really?
There must be a baseball fan on board.
Well, there's plenty of hockey fans. Whoa! Oh, bop. Da-da-da-da-da-da! Got it.
It's for Boston versus New York. Pretty good seats, too. Of course, it's been used. Things don't come that easy.
Aw. I thought it was gonna be something special because, you know, it took a hard time to open it. Really? Oh. Evidence uncovered Boston and DC. Alright, let's go here. Let's grab this. A new scrapbook. Alright. The Milan collection is one of the big five collections held in Milan, maybe? Italy, at the end of February each year. The season again saw the unveiling of many appealing and sensational items. In particular, the retro and military fashion of individualist designer Duncan matches seamlessly with current trends and was a major presence during the show. The retro and military fashion unveiled by him this season is kitsch and yet eye-catching. It's solid-based in existing paradigms. I have no idea. Paradigms? I try. While dynamically refusing them with a modern approach is likely why it has come to be evaluated so highly. Is that pop can for me? No. Of course not. Why would it be for me? No, I don't want to sit down. Why would I want to sit down? Hello, Duncan. Oh, wait. I see that your mannequin survived. She looks pissed.
Oh, ma chérie, I know. You must have been so scared.
I'm surprised she's in one piece.
There'll be champagne as soon as we arrive in DC.
Oh wait, no, that's probably why.
Might be nice.
Probably all the camo on her.
Didn't your mannequin just break?
Hey, excuse me. Shizuki, not a mannequin. Therefore, she most certainly cannot ever just break. Do you intend to make an enemy of the entire fashion industry?
No. That mannequin got totally wrecked.
Tut tut! Say another word,
matching hairdos, matching scarves.
Unleash my anger!
Okay, you win. If forget I even asked about you, Manny. My bad. No more about Suki.
That's right. She's not a mannequin. We can forget this ever happened. Of course, us being top fashion designers, we're never going to remember you anyway.
That is so weird.
Your choices in fashion, so terrible. How can one walk outside wearing that?
Military maniac, broken mannequin.
Your mannequin, is Suki really okay?
You're so persistent. Look at her smooth, perfect body. She doesn't have a mark on her.
No, she just has patches of color. Unbelievably smooth.
Suki, you are just too lovely. If I were to lose you, I doubt I could go on living.
This does look like the real Suki.
She really was
smooth. What's going on here?
I'm pretty sure it was, and then all those marks.
When did you become a military maniac?
This is fashion, you heathen. Retro and military, it's called. Both Suki and I are completely anti-war, of course.
Okay. But what I really wanted to know was, when did you change your clothes?
Progress cannot be stopped. When we changed is not what is important.
I thought he looked a little
rather
different.
The question should be, when can we change? Indeed, just look. The fashion we have on right now is already headed toward obscurity. It's imminent. Like fluttering petals. At any moment, new inspiration is going to just explode into my brain. Like,
Avant? Corn!
Avant corn!
Yeah.
Silence, you caveman! Such foolishness from a mere peasant will filthy up my brain. I'm almost there. So close. Please do not interfere with me!
Can I try that again?
So, a new trend is coming.
Very soon, yes. Very soon.
Not retro, but a new style?
Oh, yes. A new era. Acrobatic! No. Oh, no. Nonest! No, that's not it. Ah, vain!
All right, event. Avant. Garde.
Avant God!
Eureka!
Oh my god. What'd you just do, David?
Yes.
What's happening?
Your exclamation just lifted the fog from my brain in a flash! Now, say it with me!
Suki's still in the retro.
God. This will be my next theme!
Okay, well, I'm glad we helped him with that. Alright, we just need a plane. Okay, well, he's already changed. That's nice. Let's push him. Oh, I can't push her. Alright, well, bye, Marshall. I don't think I went all the way back inside here, did I? Not really, just to save?
Excuse me.
Grabbing some food. It's over there. Up.
The door looks fine.
Down, right, left. Oh, nope, I didn't get to go left. Alright, one more time, guys. We're gonna go left.
The door looks fine.
Left. Yeah, everything looks fine. Alright, let's talk to Mr. Krabby Cakes.
This is a problem. Where is it?
Object of a search. His, drugs.
Are you looking for something?
Not at all, Mr. Young. I am completely at your disposal.
Have you contacted the airport?
Yes, of course.
Are you telling me the truth?
Nope.
It looks like you're so busy searching that you haven't done anything yet.
He's looking for his drugs.
You just contact the ground.
That's very kind of you. Very well. I have lost a glove.
I thought you were only wearing one glove.
And it has to be this specific one?
Yes. It's a special order, perfectly fitted to my hand. I'm in serious trouble without it.
Okay, strange gloves.
Why is he getting so upset about a glove? He's more high-strung than he looks.
Where's Olivia?
Tell me, where did she go?
Like I said, sir, she's not aboard this flight.
That's impossible. I talked to her. And...
And what, sir?
Olivia had a gun.
A gun? Please, don't even suggest such a thing.
Olivia and a gun.
She pointed a gun at me. Are you saying I was seeing things?
I think you must have.
Are you calling me crazy?
Maybe it was a pepper shaker. Even if she was on board this flight, there is absolutely no way she would be able to get a gun on board as well.
It was a Glock 26.
I'm very sorry, sir.
I think he's part of it.
The shock of the lightning has caused you to be confused.
I'm not gonna drop this.
Whatever the case, I have to talk to her again.
Then you'll just need to keep on flying with us. If you get lucky, you'll end up on a flight with her. Eventually.
That's not really what I meant.
We're gonna find her, David. I think this guy is crooked. He's a crooked man. Crooked man being crooked man. Oh, where are these bandages? Oh. Grab bandages, bandages. Doing what bandages do. Alright, one piece missing. The case of the missing glove. Da 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 da. Grab. Alright, well, we found his glove. Oh, wait, there's a door here. Whee! Wipe away the door. Oh. Squeaky, squeak, 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 squeak.
What a beautiful sunset. It reminds me of the day I proposed.
I was like, who's outside the plane? Hi, Peggy.
Little Peggy, I'll find who killed you. I will.
Yay, we got all the evidences.
I've collected all the puzzle pieces.
The west side window.
There'll be champagne as soon as we arrive in DC.
I'm very sorry, sir. She wasn't a bull.
I don't know who you are.
That's it. This piece of the past has been solved.
Glass eye.
Are you really sentimental enough to hold on to a pen that can't even write? Unexpected. Most unexpected. You seem quite different from the man I first imagined you to be. But that doesn't mean you're totally free from suspicion.
I thought he was gonna poke him.
The same trick won't work twice.
Damn it!
Although it's still the first time for you.
Oh, God. With these powers combined...
The Fenway Park ticket was a used ticket.
What?
The seat cover pattern is cherry blossom and snow.
What are you rambling about?
The destination is in the other direction.
I don't know where he's going with this, guys.
The sun can be seen from the windows on the right side. In other words, the aircraft is flying south.
Explain yourself clearly!
I am David Young, a private detective who also collaborates with the BPD. Now you, Derek Buchanan, I consider you suspicious. If you are the one I'm after, you're gonna remain heavily involved in my investigation from now on. So let me give you this warning. I'll do whatever it takes to achieve my goal. I'll never give up. Even if it means I have to get in your way. So be ready for that.
I forgot to give the glove to that one guy.
One other thing, something I probably ought to mention. According to the BPD files, you get killed while transporting the courier known as Rabbit.
Hope we saved your life, sir. Requires investigation, David Young.
I'm going to be killed?
Dun dun dun!
Antonio Zapatero and Olivia Jones.
I never gave him his glove back.
They vanished right in front of my eyes. Literally, vanished. They didn't vanish at all. They were never on this flight. This isn't the AG Flight 117 of Boston. It's a different aircraft, heading for Washington. In other words, they didn't vanish.
Stuck on there.
I moved.
How'd you move?
Must have happened at that moment. I used the broken fountain pen to come further back in time.
Not a memento anymore. Oh, it was a memento. Can't dive.
I don't feel anything from either one anymore.
Oh, that's why the mannequin wasn't broken.
Why do you shave your beard every day? It was just starting to grow out.
Hi, Peggy.
Such a waste.
Little Peggy, what should I do?
Oh God, David, what just happened? Oh, something broke.
Damn it.
David? Playism. Access games. But who would have known that he could have jumped? It had to have been on the plane then, so it had to have been somebody on there, so all those people are suspicion, right? I like the music. Results, 1 out of 2. Game over's 1. I know. Alright, guys, you can read all those. Results, 2 out of 2. Alright. Well, we didn't get any of Little Peggy's letters this time. I didn't see any. And we got 6 out of 11 scrapbooks. There was 24 extra cases to be solved? Damn. Oh, we got Rockstar facial hair, guys. That's a lot of bottles. Dun dun dun. I I don't think whoever's on the other side of the door should answer it. This guy looks dangerous. White owl feather. The owl! Is this the old man? Hi, Teddy. Why do you look so sad, Teddy? Is that your house, Teddy, or my house? Previously on D4.
I didn't see you again this time either, little Peggy.
A passenger simply vanishing from an aircraft mid-flight. Does that sound possible to you?
Unbelievable.
What are you doing here?
This plane is going down!
Fucking with my big eye, weren't you? No more messing with this puppy!
I'm locking this one out of the park!
Yay!
You vanished? Never talk to me again!
Every time I'll break more than you watch.
I'm not sure exactly what that was, but it broke, guys. And he's really upset about it. Little Peggy?
David.
This is a story of a man.
This is the story of a girl.
Strange fate.
Hey, look. It's like I've grown wings.
Dun, dun, dun. Couldn't use the bullet as a memento. Episode 2, The Fourth Suspect. Hi, Owl. You brought death and destruction where you were. Owl. Oh, hi, David. Apparently, you're gonna die here too. So. Wakey, wakey, eggs and bakey. Stay in character for best synchro score. Huh? Bye, Owl. Where are we, David? Oh. Hello, little girl. Wait, are you Peggy as a little girl?
Who are you, mister?
It is Peggy. Oh, I nailed that.
Hey, mister, who are you?
I'm David Young. Who are you?
David? You're David?
What's that supposed to mean, kid?
There's a spot-billed duck with her duckling over there. Let's play with them.
Be careful, little Peggy. David Young, detective who investigates the past. Dun dun dun! Let's grab all the things, David. Gotta turn around and grab, and push. Oh, we pushed it away. And we have more clothes. Alright. Push. Grab. Walk. Grab. Push. Grab. Push. Grab. David, you look cold. I don't know why. Oh, I missed something up here, guys. It's go this way. Oh.
Mister, are you really David Young? You don't look like what I imagined. I heard you were really cool looking. Why do you have a beard like that?
Cause
kinda scary.
Push the kid. Yes, got it. Okay. Sorry, kid. But I really wanted that item. Alright, let's go this way. Grab that. I thought I already grabbed that. Guess not. Let's go this way. No, okay. Okay, there's nothing near her. Alright. Oh, those poor ducklings. Can't tell if that's an item set or not. That looks like an item.
You know, I almost died once.
Right on this ice?
Can you believe it? The ice on the lake just started to crack. I was so scared. But my two dads saved me. My two wonderful dads.
Two dads? But I only saw one. Alright, let's look at these poor, poor little ducks. Push! Push, 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 push! Drag and drop.
What are you doing here, David?
Why are you petting a frozen duck?
I'm looking for something.
Something?
Yeah. Something.
So, what is it?
A lead. That will let me meet someone special. One more time.
A lead? What does it look like?
I don't know.
What'll you do once you find it?
Kill him?
I'm gonna change the past.
Frozen duck statue.
You can't change the past, David.
I knew it was little Peggy.
You can't change the past. You do know that, don't you, David?
No. I can do it.
There's something right there. I just want to grab it.
Time is always moving into the future. It's always been that way.
But
you can't change the past. You just have to accept it. I belong to the past. I'm dead, David.
No!
It's so sad, but I just want to grab that one little thing.
I'm dead. I'm dead.
David, stay strong.
I am dead.
Hi, David. You're in your bathtub, don't worry. You're safe. We are here for you, David.
It's always this way. When I'm diving into the past, and I fall asleep, I get knocked out, I end up back here.
You tried so hard, David. It's okay. Wakey,
Teddy.
Wakey. There's someone in your apartment, David.
Teddy?
Amanda?
Teddy!
Amanda.
It's really gotten late. This belongs to the person who jumped me on the passenger.
Oh, sunglasses.
If this is a fragment of some sunglasses, then that narrows it down to only one suspect.
Which would be the marshal.
But is he really the type to use a stun gun? No good. The piece is unfitting, little Peggy. Huh? Teddy's laptop.
Teddy? Okay, grab. Case files.
Murders related to real blood.
That's what that guy was typing down too, real blood. Peggy. David? Look, there's something I can touch.
Look for D.
Please enter a password. Grasshopper, misdemeanor, and clam chowder. Let's go with clam chowder.
Why does he even bother with a password?
Yay, for guessing correctly.
He's using geographical profiling. BPD, a hockey rink, Diana's cafe, the Oldman Clinical Research Lab, this apartment.
Maybe he's not our friend. Maybe he's trying to get
the house little Peggy grew up in.
Why that house?
Teddy, just what the hell are you investigating?
I think Teddy was just being our friend for information, guys. He's not our friend at all. Hi, David. Oh, we didn't get to search the house, though.
Come on in, little Peggy.
Oh, God. You're not
Good
little
morning,
Peggy.
Morning, David.
Don't push yourself too hard.
That bacon doesn't look like it's cooked all the way, David. It shouldn't be that limp. Amanda, food!
So, don't keep me in suspense. Tell me, how's the case going?
The mementos are all gone.
What? How'd that happen?
Someone attacked me.
What kind of attack?
What are you putting in my drink, sir?
A stun gun or something. Knocked me right out.
So we're back to square one.
No. I do have this.
Maybe it's Teddy.
Doesn't look like much.
What it looks like is a lens from some sunglasses.
And what does that mean?
Tell me, Teddy. Do federal marshals use stun guns?
At their discretion, maybe.
But why would Derek Buchanan use one? That muscle-bound, hard-headed old schooler.
I don't know. Must have been an on-the-spot kind of thing.
Changing the subject, Teddy. Can I ask you something?
I want it. Where were you last night? How was dinner last night? Was someone here?
You didn't go home last night, did you?
That's not unusual for me.
But you always go back home. On nights when you fight with Diana.
Me and her, we've been together a long time. I got a feel for which, you know, fights are best to stay away from a little longer. Look, I'm telling you the truth. We have our own way of doing things, that's all. Huh? Oh, yeah, just forget about all that, all right?
Amanda, keep it. Amanda.
Right now, you need to concentrate on the case of the Vanishing Courier.
Baseball, I've seen it before.
This one is linked to D. That's what my gut tells me. My detective gut. Not my beer one.
I don't trust you, sir.
It's no good. I can't find anything.
You only looked through it for 2 seconds, David. Grabbing stuff from the microwave. Whee! Grab. Food. Grab. Da, 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 grab. Down. We're gonna be healthy, guys. Make ourselves a smoothie. Oh, it's a vision bonus. Okay. Grab. Whee! I think this gives us longer time to look at things, or to click on things, I mean. Not too sure though. Let's go over here, let's grab that. Fine. Grab. Need some food, David. Am I missing something? No? Okay. Band-aids! Can never have too many band-aids. Alright, let's go through this in a second. What is in that window?
It's okay. There's no problem.
I'm still wondering what's in that window. There's a package for me at the door. Package. A letter from Peggy. David, I miss you. It's quiet at night, and I sit listening to the clock tick, marking the time until you visit me. Then, after you visit and leave for work, it's the worst feeling, knowing I'm going to be lonely forever. For another day. I sometimes wish you'd never come at all. Today's your first promotion since you joined the force, isn't it? I hope you're out right now, celebrating. Have fun. It must be Forrest's first promotion, too. Congrats to both of you. I hope you're proud, because I am. Being able to sleep in my own bed still feels like a small victory. If I've learned anything these past 2 years, it's to look at everything as a gift, even the painful things. This sickness might be fate's way of telling me to keep on living. It's a different gift to handle, but as long as you're in my life, I think I can win. Right now, I'm looking forward to the both of us drinking a cold beer in the not-too-distant future, celebrating that my disease is in remission for good. Love, little Peggy, old man. Looks like she was sick before, guys. Evidently. Alright, let's go over here. There's just so much to explore in this game. Grab. Up the daisy. Extra cases, none active. I try to get back. Push, 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 push. Grab. Whee! What about this one? Letter. David, I've got a secret. I'm smiling because I want to tell you so badly, and I can't wait until you're home tonight. I was so excited when I found out that I left work immediately and came straight home. I couldn't stand to be around so many people and not be able to tell them the news. Almost there now, me. I want you, David, to be the first one to know our secret. Amanda's been unusually affectionate today for some reason. I wonder if the animals can detect a pregnancy before people can. They say cats have extra senses. I know I'm not supposed to be excited before things are much further along. I'm not supposed to be excited before things are much further along. There's just this, still so much that could go wrong. And my friends say you shouldn't jinx your luck by talking about it too early. But I just can't stop smiling. I've never thought of myself as a mother before. I don't even remember my mother's face. I wonder if she was as nervous as I am now. Well, I do know one thing. You'll be a great dad, David. I love sharing my life with you. Let's head out on this adventure together. All the love in the world, little Peggy. Grab the lollipops. Push. Ha ha. Push the squirrel. Is there anything else to grab? Grab some more firewood. Put it in the fireplace. Whee! And toss my gum out. Oh yay! Grabbing the things. Grab this. Fortune cookie. What are you gonna tell me today, Fortune? Because you know everyone punches their fortune cookie.
Will your 30-year-old self like the tattoo your 20-year-old self picked?
Probably. Punch that fortune cookie.
Enjoy doing what you don't enjoy, so you can do what you do enjoy.
I'm just gonna keep punching these cookies, guys. Tim won't let me punch no cookies no more.
Just because someone is fat, it doesn't mean they eat everything they see. Fat people can be picky too.
Aw, bye fortune cookie. Hi, Amanda. Ha! What? That baseball, we hit someone in the face with it. Amanda!
Amanda?
Bad girl. Oh, dear God.
Be a good girl and hand that over.
David, are you okay?
Give it back! Come on!
Oh. Ow. Oh, God!
Ow, ow, ow.
Up! Up! Sideways!
Over this meal.
You can't hide from me.
Hey, ooh, that tickle.
Oh God. Oh.
What? Here, eat this.
Drag, drop.
Not enough salt.
That's it.
Good girl.
Don't you dare throw it out the window, still. Amanda. Amanda. Oh God. That scream though. Oh, grab.
Quit it. Stop throwing stuff.
Grab.
That's expensive.
Oh God.
Oh, David, are you gonna destroy the entire house?
You can help out, you know.
Oh God. Grab.
Yes, gotcha.
Oh dear, good. Oh my God.
Now, Teddy.
This is the end, Amanda.
Snatch that ball. Oh, and then out the window it goes.
David, no.
Dun da da dun da da.
I don't think so.
Drag, drop, grab it. We got it, David. I'm scared of what Amanda's gonna do.
Teddy, this is a memento.
A memento? The baseball? How come? How the hell did that get in among the evidence anyway?
Because I got involved in its past. I changed this ball into a memento. Maybe I really can change the past.
Yay!
David.
We're restarting this investigation. I've made the connection, little Peggy.
Da 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 da! Memento, the ball that the courier threw in the airplane somehow found its way in the evidence. Amanda claimed it as her toy. I got involved with it, so it transformed into a memento. With this, I should be able to get back inside that plane. All right, let's turn around again, and let's go to the places we have not gone to yet. Anything over here that's not talky? Of course, it has to be this. All right, guys. Pause if you want to read this. I'm not going to read it to you guys today, or right now, anyways. But I will pause here. And pause here. And pause here. And pause here. This is a really long one. There you go. So if anyone's interested in reading all this, they can. It's right there for them. Same with this one. All right, pause here. And here. And here. And here. And here. Wow, this is a long one too. And that's the last of it. Okay. Da 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 da. I'll read those on my own time, guys. This way that you guys don't have to listen to me speak and like ruin the words and talk about hockey and stuff. Oh, I didn't want to grab that again. It won't let me do any more fortune cookies. Ha! Grab the TV.
Sebastian the Sleuth, a weekly set of 2 15-minute animated episodes, meaning he solved 2 crimes a week for the entire run of the show. Now that's what I call a super sleuth.
Bum ba da bum ba bum, goodbye super sleuth. Alright, anything in here? Nope. Alrighty. Hello, Teddy. Hello, Amanda. Let me go here and talk to you, Amanda. Oh, I can change my clothes. Hello. Cancel. I just want to look at them. Oh, hovering over them lets me look at them. go with that one. All right, changing clothes. Hi, Amanda. Annoying kitten. All right. We did that. All right. I don't like that one. I don't like that color. Maybe the pink one. Special agent. Guys, we could dress him up as a special agent. I'm gonna go with pretty in pink. See, I know I can change her clothes too. Okay, here's his clothes set. Oh my god. Oh no. You know what? We need a match. We need a match. Alright. And then, how do I change your clothes, Amanda? Oh, I can just change it. Oh, I can even change Olivia's clothes. That should be the sheriff outfit. Okay. I think I'm gonna go with the pink one and we can all just match. And then Amanda, you're going to be wearing this. Along with the ribbon. And the shoes. All right. There we go. Push, 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 push. No? Okay. Go here. Should tell me that I have an extra case open because I'm Amanda. Amanda, she seems to like it. Amanda loves presents. I'll just keep making her happy. She does all the shopping after all, so it's worth staying on her good side. Okay, what do I do? Amanda, she seems to like it. Amanda loves the presents. Okay. So I just need to find her a present? Maybe that's what's over here. And I get a new... Oh. Stamina recovery.
It hardly the time to be playing like this.
Oh, and then I didn't get in here. Da 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 da. Grab. Grab.
Hey!
Push, 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 push. Huh.
The first on the scene.
That's that guy that came and saw Teddy.
Oldman, the man who raised little Peggy. The shock was so great, it turned his hair white overnight.
Aww.
According to his testimony, by the time he found Peggy, I wasn't there anymore. As luck would have it, someone had already taken me to the hospital and stuck me in the ICU. After recovering and returning home, I found him there.
How did you come to this?
Aww.
David Young, do you think the past can be changed?
I would like it to be. Damn.
At that moment, all I could do was stand there. But now...
Now we're going to, David. Grab a drink. We're supporting your alcoholism. Oh, drag to mouth. And yeah! Drinking! We did it!
That watch. You really do wear it every day.
Hi, little Peggy. Oh, it's broken.
I bought that watch with my first paycheck. You said you'd treasure it forever.
How'd it get broken?
For good luck. So you'll come back safely to me again, my David.
I'm glad he's just having this hallucination in front of his best friend Teddy and his cat Amanda. I mean girl Amanda, whatever she is, Amanda. Drink again!
When I would drink tequila, Peggy, who didn't drink, would join me with cranberry juice and bubblegum. I don't have much of a sweet tooth, so I'd always poke fun at her. And look at me now, chewing this sweet gum and thinking about it.
Alright guys, I am actually going to call this an episode. Oh, hi Amanda. Push. Alright guys, so if you like this video, press that like button. If you want to watch more of my videos, press that subscribe button. And I'll see you all next time. Bye!